Okay, changing the water pump on the Impala SS. The water pump is located down there. This is it. So that's the water pump right there. This little circular thing with little circles inside it. That's the water pump. Now to get to it, we will have to remove the serpentine belt. And in the Impala SS, it's a bitch by every sense of the word. I mean, there's absolutely no room. This is the small block V8 we have here. And there's like really, really no room. The idle pulley is somewhere under the alternator, like somewhere down there. And there's a special tool that you can slide in, but nobody seems to have that tool, and it's not something you can find anywhere. So we're gonna do it the redneck way. So what I did is I removed the passenger side front tire, and in the Impala you have like a little cover here. It has two screws, one here, one there. Just remove these plastic screws, and what you do is you're gonna see the spring tensioner for the idle pulley. So all what we're gonna do is we're gonna loosen this bolt right here, that one, and this spring will fall down and pull the pulley with it. Now it's gonna be kind of a bitch to put it back, but this is really the easiest way, and I'm gonna show you how to put it back. So once you loosen this bolt, this thing will click, like this. It's not gonna fall all the way to the ground, but it's gonna just drop, and it could drop with a little force, so be careful and wear some eye protection. And once this drops, the serpentine belt over here will loosen, so you can remove it. And once you remove it, you'll be able to change the water pump. Now these little circle holes in it, let me zoom in on it. Inside each hole there's a screw. So you have one here, and there's another one down there. Like it's got like, I think, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm counting 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5. So in each of these little holes, there's a screw. You open 5 screws and the whole thing will drop. And have a little like oil pan, I guess, to collect the water, you know, the coolant. Otherwise, it's just gonna fall on the floor. And put another one in. Put the screws back in the same holes with the new one. And then put the belt back. And then we have to lift that spring back up and rebolt this, and you're done. Now, things to watch for. Every car has a schematic into how the belt goes around. How does it sneak around all the pulleys? Of course, in our wonderful Impala, there is no such diagram. So take a picture, draw it, do whatever you have to do. This thing has to go exactly in the same way. Otherwise, when you start the car, you will damage a lot of things. So I would just take a picture, you know? I've changed it so many times, I memorized the damn thing, but like, you just take a picture of it so you can put it back in the same way before you tension it again. So let's go ahead, and I'm gonna remove that little screw here to drop that down to loosen the belt. Okay, so here it is. I removed this screw. So this thing is loose, as you can see. It used to be in this hole here. So I unscrewed the bolt. I put my plier thingy here, and I just yanked it. So once you yank it, it'll just go plop. It's like it's gonna pop down. It won't go flying in your face or anything. And now the belt should be loose. So if you come here, see this belt right here? Now it's very loose, we can just simply remove it. So please make sure that you know the orientation of this belt. Otherwise, you're gonna have a lot of problems putting it back. Nobody knows how to put it back. Even garages, they won't even know, or they won't help you. So, and there's no diagram to tell you how this thing snakes around the pulleys and everything. So just remember it, and that's it. Me, generally, like rule of thumb, what I do is I don't remove the whole thing. I'm only going to remove it off this pulley and the water pump. Heck, actually, you don't even have to remove it at all. Just go unscrew the water pump. When the water pump falls down, these things will stay in its place. Get the new water pump and put it on top of the belt itself. I'll show you what I mean. So now I'm going to go ahead and open the water pump. Well, here's the pump. That's the old one. We just took it out. And that's the new one. The old one looks okay. It's just when it spins, it squeals. It makes like squealing noise. And also, we found the seal was broken in one area. So it was leaking also. That's the new one. And that's the new seal that you have to put. But before you put the new one with the new seal, let me show you where I took it from and how I did it. Where's the flashlight? Turn the light in the camera. So that hole right there, that's where the old water pump was sitting. And we're gonna have to actually, we're gonna have to scrape all the old seal off of here. Yeah, you're gonna scrape all the old seal off of here. So when you put the new one, it'll adhere properly and you won't have leaks. And the way I did it, how did I take it out? So this is the front of the car. I opened this piece. This piece used to be here. It has two screws, and I loosened the third one. You don't have to take it all off, just loosen it and then move it out of the way. Then I removed the battery. So that's the battery right here. And also, to get to it, because there's no room, I removed the battery holder. So the battery holder used to sit there. And that's this old disgusting thing. That's the battery holder. It's got like four screws. So you remove the four screws. Like you have one here, and one here, and another one here, and one there. And then you remove the battery holder because it's in the way. And then you'll be able to take out the water pump right here. And to take it out, the water pump, as you can see here, it has five screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Of course, this thing could spin, right? So you might not be, you might not even see the screws if it's spinning like this. So what you gotta do is just spin it till you see the screws. And then once you see them, you can feel them. Put your wrench in, it's 10 millimeter, and open five of them. And then once you open it, it's not gonna come out because it's like stuck, right? Because of this seal is stuck in the engine. So just get a screwdriver or a pry bar and just pry it open. As soon as you pry it open, it's just gonna fall off. And I use this thing to pry it open. And now we'll put the new one. So before we put the new one, I'm gonna just clean it up all around here, and then we'll stick the seal in. And once we have the seal, we'll put the new pump in, and then we'll put the serpentine belt back and put the battery holder, the battery, this little piece of metal. That's for accidents, by the way. You got like two of them. So if there's an accident, the hood will crumble that way and gives it also strength. So do put it back. And once that's done, then we go underneath. And we gotta take this thing and try to lift it up and put it here. That's gonna be a bitch, but I'm gonna show you a trick and how to do it. And that will retension the belt. And then put the tire back and you are done. Of course, don't forget to add coolant. Because like I said, some coolant will fall off. Not much, but a little bit. Have an oil pan underneath to collect the water. so it doesn't fall on your driveway or something. It's bad for the environment, and also it could like damage your driveway if you have a nice one. We're in the street, so we're not going to damage anything, but for the environment, I collect it. And if you have any questions, just ask. So I'm going to clean this, put the seal, and I'm going to film it back again and show you how it looks like. Okay, so I cleaned it here. So this is all cleaned. You have to clean all around here, so then the new seal will adhere properly. Now, there's a little nudge here, this one. That nudge here has to fit in here. So this thing is gonna go that way. And these holes must align the holes here. And the little nudge I'm talking about, this thing, has to fit in here. So the way to do it is don't put it down there. Put it on the pump itself, and in the pump you see that little nudge here, they leave a room for it, so then you must align it like that. There, so that's the nudge, and these are the screws. So it's very important to make sure that when you put the pump in, that nudge here has to align with this thing here, right here. Okay, so you have to align it with this, and all the screws will align automatically. So this is the way to do it. So now that this thing is in, let's go ahead and mount it. So this thing has to go that way. I'm gonna have to put the camera down because I need to use both hands, but just to give you an idea of how would this thing look, this thing will go that way. Like this. Okay, so I'll put it back in. It's got 5 screws, and I'll film it and show you how it looks like. So here's the new pump installed, and we put back the Serpentine belt. Now before we put the battery and everything, we're gonna tighten it. So to tighten it, we have to push this up and line it up with this hole and put the bolt back in, and you're done. And the way I'm going to do it is I'm going to use a jack. I'm going to put a jack under here and lift it up. I'm going to have one of these sockets on top of the jack, and as the jack goes up, it'll hit this thing down here. So it'll go up on it like this. So it'll go up on it and keep pushing it up till eventually that hole right here will align with this, because it's getting pushed by the socket up slowly. And once it lines up, I put the bolt in, tighten it, and I'm done. So this is my little trick in how to do it. I mean, you can use your physical strength, you know, if you're really strong. Good luck to you. Let me know if you can do it by hand. I don't think so. But why bust your balls if you can be smart, right? So that's my way of doing it. So I'm going to put the jack in, and I'll film it. I'll show you how the jack would look like and how I do it. Alrighty. So this is my jack. I'm going to put it under there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the old pump, put it in here, and then take my socket, put it in here, and take another one, fit it in here, and this thing is going to hit that spring and jack it up, at least in theory. So here's the jack, and here's the socket wrench, the socket from my wrench, jacking up that spring to align it with the hole. and I don't know if I can zoom in the hole, but it's like aligned right now. It's just the camera and the way it is. So all I have to do is just put that screw back in, tighten it, and loosen the jack and the serpentine belt. It's at a high tension right now. And that's our water pump down there. And this is how you change the water pump and loosen the serpentine belt. So now, once you put the serpentine belt back, make sure to top up the coolant fluid. And the way to do it is you gotta start your engine and then pour some and wait for it till the temperature goes high. It's gonna suck all the water, and then you have to keep adding. Like now, it's good, I added it. And until you see, let me turn off the light here so we can see better. Until you see your temperature here in the Impala SS, it goes halfway, so it's still not warm enough. So I'm gonna wait till that needle is exactly on the half mark. After that, make sure your heater works. So I have the heater on. So there's my heater, it's on. So I'm feeling like really hot air coming. That's a good sign. And once that needle goes half, keep it a little bit, make sure that it doesn't go beyond half. Then that is an indication you have a thermostat problem or something else. And once it reaches half and keep it there and the heater is on and everything working fine, go back, check the water level. And if the water level like needs to be topped up, just add it. Don't add it in the reservoir, add it from the place where I showed you. Add it right here. So that's where you add it. And then close it, shut down the engine, and then you can go and check your reservoir down there. And make sure that it's to the between the minimum and max level. That's all, and you're done. And make sure you add the proper antifreeze coolant. There's more kinds for the antifreeze coolant. I'm just here monitoring my heat temperature gauge. There's more two types of antifreeze. One that's pre-mixed, that's what I bought, simpler. And another one that you mix it yourself. You add like 50% water and 50% concentrated coolant. So I just bought the one pre-mixed because I'm gonna flush the radiator. That's another video. I'm gonna flush the radiator and the engine and everything to get all the grime and rust and crap out of there. And I'll show you how to do it. So I'm gonna re-drain all the coolant, and once the radiator is clean and flushed properly, I'm gonna buy a good brand coolant. And Prestone usually is really good. I never had problems with them, and they work well. So that's one brand you can buy. There's many other really good brands, and I'm gonna buy the one that you mix yourself. So 50-50. And for those people who put water in their radiator or in their coolant, water is no good, especially on a V8, because water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. This antifreeze coolant will boil at almost 200 or something degrees. So when your engine gets hot, you don't want the water to start boiling at 100 degrees. It creates enormous pressure on the radiator piping and everything. And then you'll get leaks and stuff happening. You want the coolant to not boil at low temperatures. So that's one important thing for you to note. Because most people think, oh, antifreeze, you know, I'm in Florida or somewhere warm and there's no snow and nothing. Why the hell would I put it? Let me just put water. You'll actually damage your car as the engine gets hot and the water starts boiling and steam gonna create so much pressure. While the antifreeze coolant will not boil. It boils at much, much higher temperature, so it stays liquid and creates a lot less pressure on the tiny little aluminum radiator. So there you have it. My gauge here is exactly on half. That's Impala SS. It'll stay there. It'll never go higher. If it goes higher, that means there's a problem. And I have the heater on and it's really, really hot right now. And I'm gonna go check the water level and it should be fine. If I need to top it, I'll add more. And the reason why we wait for the temperature gauge to reach to the maximum, its normal maximum, so we make sure that the thermostat opens up and the coolant will go inside, rotates inside the engine and the heater radiator and around the big radiator in the front. So if you need to add any more, because that's the way to do it. And there you have it. So my water here is good. I'm just gonna close it up and I'm done. And that's how you change the water pump. If you have any questions, just let us know.